Hiya, Sister Bertha. There's Christina. And there's Maria.
Well, after last night, I don't think there can be a doubt in the Reverend Mother's mind about Maria.
I gave her permission to leave the Abbey for the day.
I told you, Sister Bertha.
Ave!
Maria.
'Twas for heroism in the Adriatic.
Captain in the Navy, I'm sure he's very strict.
'Twill not be sent to his battleship, Maria.
Reverend Mother,
Trash trade.
Who wanted
and that's crippling. Now, well, let's see how long this is.
I don't have to whistle for the river, Captain. But I need myself to be with him all the time.
Not on all occasions. This is a large house and a large estate. The children have been taught to come only when they hear their singing. Now, what I want to do, this is what you would hear.
Thank you.
father's home.
How do you know my father's home?
I have a way of knowing things.
You're wonderful.
No, I'm not. Really?
Oh, yes, you are. I mean, you probably didn't know 2 days ago that you'd be here just at this time tonight to tell where you've gone.
Well, every year on this date, he always gets a birthday telegram from his sister.
You see, you are wonderful.
Could I come again tomorrow night?
Wrong. You can't be sure you're going to have a telegram from her here.
No, it was Kurt.
Kurt! That's the one I left out. God bless Kurt!
Thank you.
quite an experience for me.
You're quite an experience for me, too. Somewhere he does a fascinating man. Occasionally I catch a glimpse of him. When I do, exciting.
Exciting? I don't even call it exciting before.
I'm getting to understand you better now than I've seen you here. You know, you're a little like those mountains. Except that you keep moving. How can you be away from this place as much as you are?
Maybe I'm just looking for a reason to come back to stay.
Georg, I like it here very much.
Oh, Max can't still be on the telephone. I don't know, it's desperate for getting singers in the Carlsberg Festival, but... You like it here?
Oh, we have to spend some time in Vienna. I have quite a state to look after.
I thought that was a corporation now.
It is, and I'm president.
You, president of a corporation?
After all, I managed finance affairs for years before he died.
I can't see you sitting behind the desk.
Well, of course I wear a business suit and smoke a big cigar.
Excuse me, sir. Jack Wyler would like this coffee.
While he's celebrating.
He has just finished.
I'm sorry I took so long.
Any luck?
How would you like this for the Carlsberg Festival? The finest choral group in Austria. The greatest mixed quartet in all of Europe. And the best soprano in the world.
Max, that's something I'd love to hear.
So would I. All I've got up to now is a peso, who isn't even from Fundo.
You always come up to the festival concert?
And why? Because my motto is, never start out looking for the people you wind up getting. That's why I've been telephoning Paris, Rome, Stockholm, London.
On Georg's telephone.
How else could I afford it? Why am I up here?
I hope it was because he liked me.
Of course I like you. Live like a king. You have an excellent wine cellar.
Max!
I like rich people. I like the way they live. I like the way I live when I'm with them. Speaking as a government official. Georg, is there a cathedral around here?
Oh, yes, that's our abbey. Nonbury Abbey.
Do they have a choir?
Yes, a good one.
Good. In these next few days, I have to visit all these towns around here and listen to Sonderboons, choirs, quartets.
You'll be here for meals, won't you?
Oh, yes. It was in a town just about that size, Vatsman, where I discovered the St. Ignatius Boys Choir. In 1930, they won the festival, became very famous, toured all over the world.
Yes. Whatever became of them?
By the time their voices changed, why, they were rich enough to live in America. Who lives in that dilapidated castle down there? Rumpelstiltskin?
Baron Elphinstone. Old standing in the valley.
I'd like to meet him. Like to meet all your friends. Georg, one evening dinner from you while I'm here. Nothing very much, something lavish.
Thank you. delivered your telegram. Now get out.
Georg, he's just a boy.
I am an Austrian. I will not be hired.
Georg, why don't you look at things the way I do? Whatever's going to happen is going to happen. Just be sure it doesn't happen to you.
Max, it's a good thing you haven't any Kevin. Because if you did, I'd be convinced I would.
You couldn't hate me. I'm too lovable.
Yeah, that's why, look. There's a call for you. It's from.
I'll take it.
Later when they enter.
back into my room. I have gone.
To laugh like a brook which rips and falls over stones in its way. To sing through the night
like a lord who is longing to pray.
I go to the grave when I fall.
people, Aunt Maria.
Nice to see you again, Aunt Lila.
Yes, you're going to.
Perhaps I had a headache. She was faking. He told me you shouldn't say things. You don't know the truth. But I do know it's true. I just heard her tell Father she'd been dodging these people.
But that doesn't mean she didn't have a headache.
It's very important that these children like her, I like her all right. Why is it important? But I think she's going to be our mother. Oh, Fraulein, Father would never marry her. Why couldn't?
Why not?
Because he's in love with you.
Presto, change-o!
That's just in time, children.
God bless you, my daughter.
Are you in love with Captain Montrap?